संगम शरणं गच्छामि।
So our next question is discover the monk. In this question we are given an array of size n in which we have to deal with the q queries and we have to find an integer x. Is it available? Is it present in the array x a or not? And we have to print yes if it is present in the array or else we have to print no. So we will see the output, we will see the test cases. First of all, we are given 5, which is the size of the array, and we are given the queries which we are required to find, and in this line we are given the array and we have to find whether the test cases, the elements in the test cases are present in the array or not. First of all, the first test case is 10, so we will go to the Jamboard and now we will see whether this 10 is present in our array or not. So for this we will first of all simply do the binary search, which is which takes order of log n time for finding our solution, because the constraints are big, which will not allow our linear search because it takes order of n times, and this will give us TLE. So we will find this element by binary search in log n time. So first of all, we will sort the array which is required for binary search and make the first element as our low and the last element as our high, and then we will find the mid and we will do the ordinary calculations which are required in the binary search, that if mid value is less than our required element, which is the query, then we will simply increment low as mid plus 1, else we will update high as mid minus 1. So in this, let us suppose we get the mid as 30 and we have to find the first test case, which is 10. So we will compare that 30 is greater than 10, so we will shift our high from this to this, and our query and our array will become only this to search for the query, and then we will again find the mid, and then we will check if the mid is equal to the query, then we will simply output yes, then we will simply print yes in this case. So we can see that these elements 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 are present in the array, so we can give yes for everyone and the rest of the elements are not present in the array. So for all these the answer is simply no, and if we check that our output, then it gives the first 5 test cases as yes and the next are no. So we will go to code. Now we will see how to code this problem. First of all, we will input our n and q, and then we will see that first of all we have to sort the array, as it can be possible that our elements are not sorted initially. So first of all we have to sort the array, and then we have to take the test cases we have to search for, and we have to make a lower and upper bound, which is our low and high, which we have discussed in our approach. So till we have So till our lower value is lower than the upper value, we will find the mid and compare. If our mid is greater than x, then we will update our the upper bound, else we will update our lower bound as discussed in the approach. Otherwise, if the mid is equal to our element, then we will simply declare a flag which is the case when we found the element, and we'll simply break out the loop, and if the flag value is 1, which is true in this case, then we will simply return yes, else we will return no if we didn't get the element in our array. So this is our approach for this question.